How's Charlie, the parrot?
Show you him in his enclosure that he's been in for months. I don't know if he knows about it, and I have no intention of giving any information. The same as Dreamer. The same as his face was operated on 4 times. The same as I purposely did not admit it because I was going fucking on my ears. Do you know, sure everything you've said, there's no more fools of it.
What's your future plans for Charlie?
He's staying up in his fabulous 5-star enclosure. Charlie's flying.
And whatever happened with Fota?
They wouldn't take him because the ring on his foot is an eagle. Not the vet who wants him.
What did you say?
The ring on his foot is an eagle. He wasn't bred here.
He wasn't bred in Ireland. What does it say on his foot?
Say he was stolen or something. I don't know. Genuinely, I don't know.
Did they see his ring?
No, he took photos, but Danny did it.
What? Tell me exactly what happened.
The ring on his foot isn't legal. It's not real.
So what did you say? Danny took photos?
We took photos of the ring, yeah. If you ask the vet in Fota, they won't take him because, you know the way, say Charlie went in, even if he was blood tested and everything, I thought I had pictures of it. I think they're on Lil's page. Or they're on the AHAR discussion page. I'm going to cancel that post. They wouldn't take him, when he's not, there's no background to him. There's nothing.
So,
the vet in Fota. Is that why we're here now?
What?
This curiosity is kidding me now.
No, it's not.
Charlie,
this has nothing to do with Charlie. Look,
Charlie.
No, but I just want to know, because that was one of our first things, and I'm just going back to the start.
I know, I'll find all the pictures of him here. But I don't get.
So you said,
you can ring the vet in Fota, he's lovely, and ask him, did the girl from Killarney ring and ask to take Charlie, and ask him what he said, and you'll eat your words. They won't touch him. They won't let him inside the gate. And you can ring Cindy, and you can ask her to check out all the, look at Charlie's place. Isn't it stunning? Look at his enclosure. He's there at once, girl. I was up there once.
Uh-huh. And what was the story in the shop? How bad was he in the shop?
He was in a cat box.
What?
He was inside a cat box in the corner of the shop.
In a cat box?
Everybody knows about it.
Really?
So no,
what do you mean?
Who knows about it?
Who knows?
All the school kids were going in there knew about it.
He was in a cat box?
Inside in the corner of the upstairs building. So why don't we go now and talk to the man? Why are we going out to do this?
Talk to who?
The guy who owns the vet shop. Why do we go for a spin and talk?
It's too late
to sit here and prove to you I was telling you the truth. It's too late, Sharon.
Mm-hmm. But you said that he was plucking out his feathers.
He had no feathers when we got him, Sharon.
No feathers?
I had feathers missing all over him, like.
Have you got photos?
In the disc, probably the memory chip, yeah.
Will you send them to me?
Of course.
Will you promise me that?
Of course I will. But why don't we ring Seamus now? Sure, he was there. Why don't we put Seamus on loudspeaker?
Seamus?
My ex-Seamus.
Seamus Fogarty?
Yeah, sure, you remember Charlie.
No, there's no need.
We can drive to the pet shop now.
And
why wouldn't you drive to the pet shop?
You said that he was really thin.
Yes, of course he was. Why, you think I'm a hoarder and I wanted Charlie? You for real?
You promised me and Marjorie and Annette that
That what?
That you were going to send him to Fota.
Yeah, and they wouldn't do. Like, it's this Charlie business. It's this Charlie. It's this on about Charlie shit, like.
Okay, look, just forget about it.
But I'm
have you got a handbag?
No.
Look, can I just give you this?
Yeah.
And you can just read this stuff in your own time, okay?
What is it?
Just read it yourself.
What is it?
That's your copy. Okay.
What is it, Sharon?
This is my copy. I'll take out my copy of it.
What do you want about, like?
You can just read this in your own time, okay, Suzanne?
What's it about?
This is what it's about.
Like, the only reason you're here is you're in trouble about something. Because you don't give a shit about me or AHAR, Sharon.
Listen, okay.
You wanted me in jail, like.
Listen, Suzanne. This is right.
What?
I rang Fota.
Yeah.
They said they had no contact from you at all.
That is bullshit, and I can prove it. I'm gonna wrong your ass on this.
Yeah.
Best thing you ever gave me.
They said, and they said they could provide him that you never contacted them, and they could provide him with a home with other blue macaws and
not in Fota. Not in Fota.
Yes, in Fota. Look, Fota.
Well, do you know what I'm gonna do? I'm going to absolutely shame you on this, because I am gonna make that fit ring you.
Go on.
Oh, I'm going to.
Yeah.
Anyway, what's next?
That was my contact with them, saying thanks. This is from Breda in the pet shop.
Yeah.
Saying no bird ever had to be rescued from the shop.
You bought him? How was he rescued?
I did not buy him.
Yourself and the girls gave me the money to buy him.
We gave you the money to buy him.
Yeah.
For the purpose of going to Fota.
But you forget, the mother that works inside in that shop, her daughter still volunteers with me. And she thrilled to death that Charlie was leaving the pet shop. If I wanted a fucking parrot...
He said he was in an aviary, 6 foot high by 6 foot wide.
Nope.
And he was in perfect condition and excellent shape.
Nope.
Yeah, and she's...
And what about, what's her name that saw him with all the chest feathers and the tail feathers gone? What's her name again? Give me her name. The girl that came down to me. She's her girlfriend.
Oh, Annette.
Annette saw him with all the chest feathers and the tail feathers
gone. She said he was perfect. Anyway, according to Breda, he was perfect, right? He was an actual celebrity. People used to come in to meet him.
He was a celebrity in a fucking dark corner of the fucking pet shop.
Marsh has made a stinker of a statement there, ready to go up on Facebook. It's already posted, but set to private. It can go to public at the press of the
letter.
Yeah, which I will share up on my Facebook
page
as well, if it goes public.
Yeah, not about
Suzanne.
It.
That's all
I'm going to be going out of it.
Yeah.
That's lousy.
It just says here, it's all on it.
But you know what?
Start to finish.
I love this. Yeah. Because I'm going to fucking disgrace you. I'm going to prove the truth to you.
Yeah. Well, do.
And you know when that goes public? There's no bother. I'm going to put up everything on the AHAR page. Everything. Every fucking email, every private message, everything. And I wasn't.
No,
I'm going
to
do it.
From your Facebook page saying that he had to be... from your AHAR, your website, saying that he had to be saved.
He did,
from a pet shop.
Let it up.
There's going to be...
You came all the way down about this.
Yes. There's going to be... if you don't give me Charlie today...
You can go away and drop dead. What kind of blackmail that is?
If you don't give me Charlie...
Not a bother. Not a bother.
Within half an hour.
Not a bother. Let it up.
Going up on
not a bother. Let it up.
Yep.
Yeah.
Not
a bother.
There's a petition.
Not a bother. Not a bother.
Yeah. That's everything, Suzanne.
No problem. Let it off. You're not going to bully me anymore, like.
I'm not bullying you.
You are a bully, Sharon.
Look at...
You are a bully. Going around telling everyone to jail Suzanne.
I am not. Will you stop?
Really?
Suzanne.
So is Carolyn a liar, that you said you want to see me in jail? Is Carolyn a liar? Will we ring her?
Listen.
Will we ring her?
Listen.
What you did to me was absolutely outrageous. I was never friendly with her. Why were you fucking ringing me 24/7 so you weren't friendly with me? It's not my fault you having the balls to stand up to those witches. It isn't my fault, Sharon. Why are you afraid of them?
Look at... You can hand him over...
I'm not handing you nothing.
You can hand him over...
Whatever cop to yourself.
With no fuss.
You're a bully. You came down here to bully me, like. About a parrot. Sharon, I actually thought you were in trouble. Do you know what I thought? I actually felt sorry for you. I thought you were after saying something to Yuta, and she was trying to destroy you or something.
Do you want to read that fit now?
Get a number there.
What?
Get a number.
Would we ring... Fota Island.
I presume he's on second on the list, any. How do we get his number? No, do you know what we'll do? How about I drive down, and how about I buy a dictaphone and I record him? And how about I put it up on Facebook as well?
What?
And record him talking to me. You're, like, even if you find out now, that I did ring the vet, which is simple to find out, right? Even if I go on the phone and say, I'm the girl that rang you, and I jog his memory or whatever, maybe, I don't know how many vets are there, but I spoke to that, anyway. And I find it, and I prove to you I rang him, right? And yeah. I prove to you what he said to me.
Yeah.
It doesn't make no difference to you.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't make any difference to you, like. You're still on this psychotic mission, like. It makes no difference to you. Even if I prove to you I'm telling the truth, which I will now, out of spite.
Well, can you prove to me now?
Listen.
Prove to me now.
You'll be onto something else now. You will be, next week it'll be a 20 grand dress I bought. Imagine a 20 grand dress.
Who said that?
You. She said that you told her, she's on Facebook, that you told her I could dress for 20 grand. And you now have the receipt.
Oh my God, that is absolutely ridiculous. I certainly did not say that.
But are you not embarrassed of this behaviour, like? Are you not embarrassed to have the likes of Yuta and all them as friends? Are you not embarrassed that you're involved in a fucking hate campaign for your friend's rescue? Are you not embarrassed? You're not, obviously.
Cole, this is Fota now. Sharon Shannon here. Hiya, how's it going? Is Sharon the Coon there?
Yeah, I'm just checking in.
Okay. Okay, what's the name of your vet? What's the name of the vet? Can I speak to the vet?
Can you get a mobile from and ask is he there for the last 3 years? Is it the same vet that
was there? Is it the same vet that was there in 2011? Okay. And what's his name? Don Hutchie? What's his name? Phone number? Thanks. Pat Doherty. Mobile number in your phone.
Oh, that's the new phone number.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. So you have no mobile number. Okay. Thanks very much. Thanks. Okay, bye. Bye. I don't have his mobile number, Suzanne.
Can you get a copy of that number?
Yeah. Phone. Okay. 021 496 2799 Hello, how are you doing? Can I speak to Pat Doherty, please? It's okay, thanks. Have you got his mobile number?
I'm Sharon Shannon. I'm not going to run off his
number. Okay, thanks very much. Bye-bye.
When's he going to be there?
He's on holidays.
Do you know, it just dawned on me. Do you know how he'd remember me? When I was in the Grand Parrot Hotel in Cork, there was a, I can't remember, a bigger, whatever the bigger version of Charlie is, and when the Grand Parrot Hotel closed, they gave, Gerard Lucy gave them the, he's a bigger blue, she's a bigger Lucy's name, because of his name was Gerard Lucy, and he gave them the, that parrot, whatever, it's not a parrot, it is a parrot. And she's still below there. And I remember telling him that story, and that's how he'll remember me. I said to him that she took the parrot from the Grand Parrot Hotel. Lucy is her name, and that's how he'll remember me. So now, just wait. And you know when it is proved that I was telling you the truth, that I wanted them to take him? What's next? What's her next vendetta? It's never going to be enough, like. It's going to be Charlie today, it's going to be the 20 grand dress tomorrow, it's going to be a husky next. But you know the sad part of all this, and you knew at the time, the husky from Cavan was neutered and chipped. Georgia homed it between Ratmore and Mystery to the school teacher, right? And she knows she drove that dog there. Funny how the dog from Cavan was an adult old dog. Funny how his ass was a puppy. Funny how his balls were hanging out, Jerry.
On your Facebook page that the Cav dog was 10 months old. It's written on his photograph.
Okay, but I thought he was older. But he had bought, the fella from Cavan had no balls. He had no balls. How did the dog grow balls? But how did the Cavan dog grow balls?
There is no, show me the update of the Cavan dog.
Brian, you can actually ring in the second, he'll tell you. We are searching for her. We're ever going to find her. And there's going to be some laugh and a whole lot of it.
So you don't know where the dog is?
She used to deliver the dogs. Truthfully, you know that yourself. And Georgia knows. Do you know, if we rang Caroline there, Georgia told Caroline, and Caroline's willing to tell you, and she laughed at Caroline. And Caroline said, you're lying, and she said, I don't care. Sure, give a fuck, like. You didn't get me in jail.
So you don't have an update. You're saying the dog is, where is the dog?
Between our home and the street. That's where Georgia said she went. Don't worry.
Where the dog is.
She's a school teacher. She can't be that hard to find, Sharon. Never did any of the home. I didn't, like, and you know I didn't. You know that. You know I never took the dogs anyway. Georgia drove them to the vets and drove them out. So. But I don't care. What are you going to do, like? What exactly do you want? Do you want the farm or buffers? Is that what you want? What do you want?
I worked so hard.
And look at all the thousands of animals that have been saved.
Try and get
years.
That place.
Yeah? For look at the thousands of animals.
For AHAR.
Yeah?
Not for you. For AHAR.
But your house is mine. How is that place mine? The deal is that it stays in AHAR forever. And that we try and get the money to put up a fancy kennel so that when I'm dead and gone, AHAR stays. That's the deal, like.
And who owns it?
What do you mean who owns it? AHAR owns it. The committee owns it. Or not the committee, the trustees.
And who's the trustees?
No intention of answering you.
Yeah.
I have no intention of it, like.
Yeah. Well, I didn't think you would. Yeah.
Why should I give you information?
Yeah.
To go trying to jail me and stuff.
Yeah, I absolutely.
But AHAR is still doing it.
So hard to get that place.
Look at all. Are you telling me that you don't see the hundreds of animals we're saving coming in and out the gate all day long? And you don't see Gail taking 25 dogs a week? So, what is your qualm? We're doing what we said we were doing. I went to Christine's wedding 4 days off, Sharon. First time in 10 years. First time in 10 years, I had 4 days off.
You're not going to give me...
Well, my foot giving you, Charlie. Do you know, if you rang me and were nice to me and said, look, I have some place fabulous for him, I'd be delighted with you. But not this bullying tactics.
So you won't let him go to Fota Island, to this fantastic place?
If it was genuine.
Why not?
If it was genuine.
He's been offered a place at Fota.
Allowed in the gate. And all of a sudden there's no problem with disease or anything. Even though he offered to blood test him and prove that the bird wasn't...
You told me that he did loads of blood tests.
What do you mean, who did loads of
blood tests? You told
Tom, me. Why don't you ring Tom
several
on the
times.
Ark? Why don't you ring Tom on the Ark? Danny was only barely... Danny was just even at the time, I don't think so. Why don't you ring Tom on the Ark? No, do you know what?
You told me
it's
Fota,
actually funny.
You Suzanne, you told me Fota taught you that he had to do loads of different blood tests and this test and this test.
And
that
might never be allowed
test.
In. Might never be allowed in the gate.
Yeah, but you said you did all these tests.
And
you sent them to
prove it all.
We'll
prove it all. We'll prove it all. Why would you want Charlie to leave his home? Why would you want to? Like, he's a ball up there with all the volunteers.
To go to Fota Island, as was promised by you in 2011. I'm going to turn this off again.
But that's like me going up and taking a dog off here. Why would you do it? Why would you do it like? What's wrong with his beautiful enclosure? What's wrong with it?
My dog
isn't as good as Fota.
It's my dog. I'm the carer of my dog. Charlie is not your bird.
What's wrong? He's not my bird.
He's not yours. He was never meant to be for you.
But sure, it's not that I wanted to keep him. Obviously, everyone got attached to him then. Do you know what I mean? What's it going to be next week, would you like? What's going to be the week after?
I know now that you've made no genuine attempt
but
to get him into
get me that bet. Because that's the thing. He will remember the story about
Lucy. I don't believe you, Suzanne.
Sure, I don't care. But I don't care, like. I don't care what you believe.
Mm-hmm.
I don't care.
Suzanne, I'm not even going to show you the rest of the stuff.
That's fine.
If you want to read Marge's post and stuff, it's put up in...
I don't care.
An hour from now, I think.
But this is me. Do you realize that you're... You're not giving me a choice, you're a bully.
I'm giving you a choice. You can let this happen nice and quietly with no fuss. Just give him over and let him go to Fota as promised. With no fuss at all.
Why didn't you ring me nicely last night, right? And why didn't you say, Suzanne? Fota, will you stay, Charlie? Why aren't you nice about it? What's this bully tactics?
Because I don't trust you, Suzanne.
You don't trust me?
I don't trust
come
you.
Here.
Would you hear me? Suzanne, what you would probably do is sell a cheap macaw.
Not a thing, they're 2 grand.
I've looked them up. There's you can get cheap ones in
Ireland. You have to cheap
you can look it up on
a baby Molly is about 800 euro.
Come here, look it up yourself. You can get them on Dundeal and everything for under 500 quid, 300 quid, 400 quid. That's, I don't trust you. That's what you do. You would get them and you could cheap ones. Fota. I know you well, Suzanne, I know you well. Anyway, you have an hour.
I can't stop. I'm going to be late.
Okay?